This is how many therapists often work. They have a sensitivity in their emotions, whether they are consciously aware of it or not, in which they are feeling the exchange of emotions happening within their clients or within other people. They are studying the emotions in many ways, and then using this knowledge to better assist their clients. In a similar way, someone with mastery of the physical body, be it an exercise master, a fitness guru, a chiropractor, a doctor, an athlete, they can watch the body with their eyes, listen to the body with their ears, hearing the movements, hearing the stepping of feet, hearing the rate of breathing. They will use the five physical senses to study the physical body of themselves and of others, and thus better understand it. And so listening with our emotions is but engaging the senses of our emotional body, of our energy body. This is done in a similar way, that one would listen with the eyes by watching, or the ears by hearing, or the hands by feeling, in the physical body. We are simply learning to expand our awareness into these layers of our being to give ourselves direct personal knowledge of that which is happening. This can be applied to the mind as well. We can learn to listen to our thoughts. What patterns of thinking operate within us? What does the mind desire? While we listen to the voice within our head, we can also feel the energies, the soft, subtle energies associated with these thoughts. Desire has a certain flavor, a feeling to it. Intent has another flavor, a feeling to it. We can feel the subtle energetic changes that happen with each thought. These are different than the chakras and the emotions. These are softer. These happen in the guna energies, the sattva, raja, and tamas, or the yin-yang. Very, very soft, subtle movements of energy that arise before the grosser emotional states. Then, dear ones, once we have taken our awareness beyond the body, emotions, and mind, once we have learned how to study them within our awareness, then we can take our attention and place it upon that which is observing. It goes beyond your vision. It goes beyond your feeling and your thought. You can be aware of that which is completely still. It has no vibration. It has no texture. It has no form. By being aware of the formless, you become the formless. And so, just as we study the body, emotions, and mind, we can study the consciousness, the eternal self, that does not change because it has no forms, that is infinite because it has no boundaries. By taking your awareness beyond all activities, you will discover yourself as being this eternal consciousness. This is what the universe exists as for eternity. Whether forms are created or not, this eternal emptiness, stillness, space, awareness, consciousness will always exist. It is what you are for eternity. And the mind, the emotions, and body, the manifest universe, is what you are doing right now. It is all a temporary experience occurring within the eternal. It is an ever-changing experience happening within the changeless. In order to know the deepest peace, in order to remove all fear, in order to conquer all insecurity, to remove all illusion, you must know this eternal state and realize it as yourself. You do not need to push away the mind, the emotions, or body to discover it. Having the belief that the mind, body, and emotions are in some way keeping you from your eternal self is but an illusion, but a trick, a misunderstanding in your mind. Nothing can be keeping you from that which is eternally present. Truth cannot be created or destroyed. It always exists. Nothing is keeping you from truth, because it has always existed right now. It is simply that you are not fully perceiving it. You are it, but you are looking out into the mind, emotions, and body. And as you have looked out, you have forgotten that which is looking. It is that simple. Stop looking at your thoughts. Stop looking at your emotions. Stop looking at your body. And just be that which is looking. Be the source of looking and feeling. Be the stillness and the emptiness. No desires arise from within this place, because all desires are of the mind. No emotions arise from this place, because the emotional body is only communicating from its own dimension out. The body is not even felt from this place.